much I earned boxing and how much I'd spent on boxing, and I was minus £3,500. I need this job for the money to basically further my career.
Well, since I've lost my job, my bank balance is in the minus and my savings are completely gone. Credit cards is what I'm living off at the moment. It's the first job I've been offered in months, so I'm not going to lie, I'm going to take it.
Jack, Tommy and Gemma have each signed up for a job on the other side of the world that can pay very well, if they can hack it. Four weeks sheep shearing in New Zealand.
A lot of sweat, blood and tears in this game.
This is one of the toughest manual jobs going.
Head butted, kicked onto the floor. These are 100 kilo animals. I don't want to be here.
The only experience with an animal that I've got is I've got a hamster.
A major concern is a sheep kicks me in the nuts.
It's back-breaking work. The hours are long and conditions gut-wrenching.
It's a dirty job and you start off in the shit.
The whole shearing game is surrounded around sheepers and sheepers.
Smells make me feel sick. Why would you want to be near it like a farm?
The reason is very simple. It's all about the money.
I can earn earnings of $2,500, $3,500, $7,000 a week.
Every year, seasonal workers flock to New Zealand from around the world chasing the big bucks.
It's definitely some good money to be earned. It sort of comes down to the individual and how much money do you want to make.
But if the Brits can't cut it, they'll be on the next plane home.
You get a heap of greenhorns from all over the world have a go at this job and realise real quick that it's just too hard for them, and they pack the bags and see you later.
It's a real hard job to be in. It's very physical and very demanding. It's hard work.
19-year-old Gemma from Sheffield has never really had to graft for her money.
What's manual labour? Is it just like proper hard work?
But now, Gemma needs the cash.
Cheers, girlies!
I go all the time, I go crazy, I love to dance, freaking everything, I love it.
Any money Gemma does have goes on just one thing, Gemma.
As soon as I get money, I'll be gone in an hour. I'm always skint because I hate not having nails and my tan done.
Someone, I need support.
Gemma does not understand the value of money whatsoever. She'd rather go and spend money on alcohol and clothes than food or proper stuff that she really needs.
Gemma's never had a proper full-time job, and the money she earns one or two nights a week as a nightclub hostess hardly covers the cost of her manicured nails.
I spend about £50-60 a week on my beauty regime. I have at least a quarter pack of extensions every week. Just have like an obsession with it.
But Gemma doesn't have enough money, so Mum and Dad end up footing the bill.
I sort of try to keep a tally of what Gemma's borrowed, and it gets quite difficult. I definitely think it works out over a couple of thousand.
I think I'm very good at getting money out of my dad. I know how to win him over, do you know what I mean?
In a way, we've sort of created our own problem, I suppose, and not saying no often enough.
But now, that's exactly what they're saying.
They're giving me less and less, so I'm getting a bit worried about that, but that's why I need a job.
Sheep shearing in New Zealand will be a tough physical challenge for Gemma, but that's not her biggest concern.
What do sheep shearers wear? Maybe do they wear dungarees? I've got dungarees.
Queenstown on New Zealand's South Island. After a 36-hour flight and armed with their working holiday visas, Jack, Gemma and Tommy touch down on the other side of the world. The trainee's new boss and former champion shearer, Mouse O'Neill, is waiting to meet them.
I don't think they'll have any idea of the hard work it takes to be in a wool shed. These guys are going to get a real shock come 5 o'clock tomorrow morning.
All right.
Kia ora, mate. How's it going?
Hi, how
Mouse?
Are you?
Good. Welcome to New Zealand.
Jack. Yeah, nice to meet you.
How's
I'm a bit deaf on the flight.
Oh, OK.
Yeah, still
paying. How are you? Geez, you're a big solid bugger, aren't you?
To reach Shearing HQ, a drive through the hills of central Otago, deep in the heart of sheep country.
Pretty awesome, isn't it, this countryside?
Wow, gorgeous.
It's not like Blackpool, is it?
For Mouse, it's a chance to suss out his new employees.
Do sheep bite?
They'll only bite you if you put your hand in their mouth.
You're scaring me a little bit, you know.
Are you guys used to physical work in that, or?
No, not at all. I work in an office, well, I did. Can I give you a CV?
Yeah.
21-year-old Jack from Bolton has been working and fending for himself since he left home as a teenager.
Are you taking anyone on the time? Leaving home so early forces you to go up. I had nothing to do but get a job and pay rent and pay bills and council tax and water. And so I've been doing that since before I was 17.
But a few months ago, Jack lost his job.
I used to work for a ticket agent and the office got burnt down. So ever since that, I've been job hunting and living off credit cards. I've got no money left at all. I've had to sell my wardrobes to make some money.
Now with no regular income, he's struggling to keep a decent roof over his head.
Any of the money that I hopefully make from being abroad, I hope to move out of the property that I live in because it's full of damp, smashed windows, it's trampy, it's horrible.
For Jack, New Zealand could be the first step in turning his life around.
I'm really hoping like this trip will financially sort me out, it'll make me more stable.
Shearing sheep will certainly be a new experience for him.
You've got to make sure that you know where the boys are girls because you can cut the bits off.
How am I going to know that when it's full of wool like that?
Can't they have horns? Device.
I know nothing about sheep. I just know they've got wool on them.
Shearing HQ and a ready-made camp known as the Quarters.
Oh my days.
It's like a
garden shed.
During peak season, as many as 170 migrant workers can be living here.
So this is the Quarters, guys.
For the next 4 weeks, it'll be home to Gemma, Jack and Tommy.
I've got no mirror!
That is the worst thing I've ever seen.
Are you going to smell it?
I think I'd get fucking ill.
It's not what I was expecting. It suddenly makes me room with damp in it look like a five-star hotel. What is that?
Well, it looks like dried...
Jizz.
What's you got a chicken bone behind your head?
Oh, that's disgusting.
Oh, my God. I just don't want to sleep in there. Can I just go to my hotel? It's disgusting.
The accommodation's real basic, but got to go where work is. Need the money. So just got to do it, get on with it, don't moan about it. Just got to suck it up.
For the last 4 years, 24-year-old Tommy from near Lancaster has been fighting his way up the boxing ladder.
I believe I've got what it takes to get to British level and defend my belt outright. And then from there, obviously, the sky's the limit. The dream is to become British champion.
Unfortunately for Tommy, it's a dream that doesn't pay.
I was working as a plasterer part-time because I trained that much. But because of my boxing, having to pretty much train full-time, they've had to let me go. So, essentially, now I'm unemployed for chasing my dream.
And with no money, his only option was to move back in with his mum and stepdad.
It was getting too expensive for him to live away from home. Living here makes it a lot easier for him.
Tom is hoping that sheep shearing will give him the financial boost he needs.
Tony needs this cash so much to fund his boxing career, for his foods that he needs, getting to and from training, and it'll be just one less thing off his mind, really.
Good! Get in on him!
But for Tommy, it's not just about his career.
This money's going to help me out with everything. It's going to help out in my family life as well. I'm a grown-up now, and I should be funding stuff myself and not relying on my parents. They've done their bit.
...4:30 a.m. at Shearing HQ.
Yup, Jimmy.
The start of the working day.
Good morning, mate.
How are
you doing? You up nice and early, eh?
Oh.
OK, yeah. I'll see you shortly, eh?
See you soon. I'm tired.
Oh, can I just go back to bed?
Gemma, Jack and Tommy will be joining a shearing gang.
All right, guys, so when we get up in the morning, we come along and check the board for your name.
Okay.
So that's
at the top there, yeah. It's the farmer's name.
They'll be working with gang leader and top shearer, Harmy, and shed hand Stevie and Tui.
All right, let's go, eh?
With around 30 million sheep spread across the country on remote farms, shearing gangs have a long commute to work. Today, it's a two-hour journey. For the pros, it's a chance to catch up on some sleep. For the newbies, a chance to get nervous.
Shit just got real. Do you feel like you know what to expect?
No.
No, I don't. It's a bit different from the office at all.
Working as a shearer is where the big bucks are made.
Come in, guys, and I'll just show you around.
But before the new arrivals can get their hands on the clippers, they need to learn the basics, working as a shed hand on the equivalent of £9 an hour.
You take it, Mick? Oh, Jesus.
Is that poo?
Yeah.
Their first task is to ensure a steady supply of sheep to the waiting shearers, a process known as penning up.
So the thing we've got to do is get a pen full of sheep from there over here. We get in here and chase as many in there as we can.
Yeah.
Let's go, move here, we'll show them. I'll work the gate, okay? So you just, that's it.
While Tom is happy to get hands on, Gemma's not quite so keen.
Oh, I don't want to do that. I'm not doing it. I don't like it.
Just relax.
You got a sec?
I don't like it. Papa's stressing me out, you know.
Get him to it.
The shearers are desperate to start earning, but it seems Gemma's experience of managing clubbers in Sheffield hasn't prepared her for herding sheep.
Oh, I really don't want to do it.
You don't want to do this?
It just looks like they're going to hurt me. No, what am I supposed to do here? I don't get it.
Right. They're only running because I scared you.
No, but they're going to all run into me.
No, they won't.
By the neck.
Jump in here, check.
Oh, I'm freaking out, you know. Oh, fuck.
Jack and Tommy are left to deal with the sheep on their own.
Oh, my God, they're coming out. Shit.
Let John at the front. Oh, no, on your side.
Oh, my God. See, they tried to kill me then. That's not a woman's job, that.
Not a lady-like woman, anyway.
Mm. Oh, my God. Papa freaked me out.
Jack, the quicker we can get those pens loaded up, then those guys can start making money.
Right, okay.
The shearers are paid per sheep, so the trainees must keep feeding them through as fast as possible.
How the fuck are you going to share then? Like, what's fucking out there?
These lambs are just tiddlers. Later in the week, they'll have to deal with fully grown sheep four times the size.
I suppose one's a bit me.
And anyone who can't keep up won't last till payday.
Oh, I've got two on there. I'm stuck as shit right now. I'm not even lying to you.
Why were you not scared? Why was it just me?
Because I'll regret it if I go home and don't give it a shot. He's good at it, though, because he's strong.
I know, we just went in and was like...
No, but one jumped into his back, like, mid-back.
Was it prop on his back?
Yeah.
I literally, like, was it...
It was funny, though, mid-back.
I felt like I was getting bummed by a sheep.
What the hell? If that happened to me, I'd cry.
If Gemma can't overcome her fear of sheep, she's no use to the shearing game.
Go in there. Have a walk around.
Look how aggressive they are.
Keen to show that sheep handling can be women's work, Tui and Stevie persuade Gemma back into the pens.
What do I hold? Ah!
That's all right.
I don't know what to do.
Just turn it.
Yeah, that's all right. It's just gone that way.
Of course she's going to be scared. She's probably thinking they're running at her, yeah. But they're not. They're running away from her.
If they come near, you sort of just scare them away with us.
Get away from there!
I think Gemma is not going to cut it in this game. When I first seen her, I thought, holy shit, is she actually coming to work or coming to do a photo shot for Sports Illustrated?
I'm holding on to this bag for, like, dear life, literally. That was the worst experience of my life.
The new recruit's first shift is over.
See you tomorrow.
See you.
Well, I feel a bit better about sheep after being in. I want to come and shear sheep. I want to be, like, proper, like, woofing them about and being like, yeah, next one, please, instead of crying in the corner.
Oh, I've got shit all the pants.
You've got to start at the bottom, and the more you want it, if you want more money, you want a better work, you just got to get on the grind and get there.
I shit my face at one point, I was like that. Even the basic over here, it's the equivalent to nearly £9 an hour, which is way above the minimum wage back in the UK. And the fact that you then go on to the shearing, which is even better.
The question is, will they make it that far?
The future for Jack and Gemma while they're here, I'm very worried about it. They look like they're really going to struggle.
It was the easy part of our job. Wait until they see the real thing and, yeah, they'll get a fright.
Tomorrow, the dirty work really starts. And it's called crutching. Rather than taking off the whole fleece, just the wool around the sheep's backside is shaved off to keep away maggots. but even that wall is valuable.
Today it's going to be separating the poos from the good wall. So you have to bend down
and
actually take the poos out of the wall.
You get gloves though, don't you?
No, no,
you don't use gloves. Don't have nails.
You can take your nails off and cut them.
I don't have any.
Or you can just clean them really good when you finish.
I won't be able to eat ever again in my life.
You're just going to have to deal with it because, you know, that's what we do.
Yeah.
But Gemma really doesn't want to deal with it.
That's not a glove.
Oh my god, it's fine, you put it up, it's bomb.
Protection. If I have one hand like free and one hand with a glove, it works really well.
Gloves are not normally part of a shed hand's wardrobe.
I've been in the industry for probably 25 years and I've never seen anyone put a pair of gloves on, so I was very shocked when I seen that and a little bit sort of pissed off. I should really get rid of that.
What?
That glove. Because the farmer said to me about them.
What did he say?
Well, he thinks that you're not going to be doing the wool properly if you've got a glove on.
Am I not allowed to use it then?
No.
Okay.
I'll get it.
That's a bit annoying, isn't it?
With Jack boldly leading the way.
I've never picked anything like this up, ever.
Gemma gets stuck in.
Is that warm as well?
In this job, you really do have to get your hands dirty.
Oh, that's horrible. You've
got to get through 2,000 sheep.
Tommy, meanwhile, is back in the pens, doing his best to keep the shearers supplied with sheep.
At the moment, I'm just using a bit of strength, but I don't think that'll last long, so I'll be knackered.
Gang leader Harmy is impressed.
Tommy, yeah, big strong lad. You'll go a long way in this game if you want to get into it. That is bloody hard work doing that, cleaning up. Even for experienced guys, they still do it hard, so he done well.
While Tommy seems to have settled into his new environment...
I can't believe you've never wore eyelashes.
No,
that's mental.
Gemma's still struggling to make sense of hers.
Yeah, I mean, like, do you not, like, care about your parents as much, like, while you're here? Not, like, in a bad way, but, I mean, like, are you not that arsed about putting, like, mascara on and stuff, like...
I do wear makeup to work sometimes.
Yeah.
When I can be bothered and when I want to look pretty or impress someone.
Yeah.
But every other day it's just... tights, hoodie, singlet.
Yeah.
So, she's come up with a plan.
I'll make you all up. I'll beautify you all. Yeah, and then we'll go to a few bars. No, maybe pre-drink for a little bit in my room.
Oh, yeah.
Yeah.
If I get dressed up, then I'm going to feel out of place.
I'm excited to see your dress up. It's cute, that, isn't it?
Just do what you did on that leg, on that leg.
So, after 2 days of being taught, Gemma turns instructor.
She's teaching me how to tan.
I'm teaching you how to tan.
In her favourite subject.
I haven't done anything like this before. It's all new to me.
Meanwhile, Tommy's talking shop with Harmy.
Never done a job where I've had to change my top pretty much 3 times a day.
Gotta work every muscle in your body and muscles that you didn't know you had. There's a breaking point. And this is where we're trying to get you guys to, that breaking point.
I won't be broken. Fact.
Oh, I doubt that.
Good, good.
I doubt that.
Yeah.
From what I've seen so far.
Good.
I'm putting fake lashes on for the first time in my life.
Is this normal before you guys go out?
Yeah, it takes me about 2 hours
to get ready. Wow.
It
takes
really?
Me about 5 minutes.
Welcome to Jimmy
Bros. Where are we going? It's like, no one else is going to be dressed like this.
I think all the girls look really pretty. They scrubbed up very well.
I can't
like help. Me. They look like me. Mini versions of me.
Time for Gemma and her mini-me's to hit the town, Sheffield style.
It's weird, like, because normally I'll be like, oh, bar, 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 nightclub, somewhere else. But, like, now I'm like, what's going on? I don't understand their way of life.
Gemma may not understand it, but Jack is starting to see the appeal of their new surroundings.
The nightlife seems nothing like what it is in Manchester. It's really dead, quiet.
Yeah.
Like, and all the Kiwi guys from the farm and stuff, they're all buying shorts and stuff like that. And the whole trip too, because it's like a family. And it's been dead good.
Being part of the close-knit sharing gang is a big change for Jack, who's been fending for himself since leaving home at 17.
My childhood was crap. It was shit. There's nothing else to say about it. It was just like, you know, I had a dad who left me, and then when I was 15, I got asked by my mum, are you gay? Obviously, I responded, and I said, yeah, yeah. And at that time, I got told to see either a psychiatrist or get out. And of course, any logical person knows it's not a choice, so I got out and didn't see a psychologist. And, you know, I'm on my own since. It's not what you see on TV all the time, where they come out and they're fine with it, and you feel shit, you feel like something can't be right.
It's another 5 a.m. start for the sharing gang and another 100-mile commute. After days of crutching, the trainees are attending their first full shear.
All right, guys, these are Merino fleeces that we're doing today. So it's a real fine product. So we've got to go through and make the farm as much money as we can out of this stuff here, OK?
For the next 3 days, that means working as wool handlers under the watchful eye of head honcho Adam.
So we're taking off all the oddments, like all the ugly stuff, which is the neck, the back, and the pieces on the side. And we're just like plucking with our fingers.
Oh, it's a bit of a cottage.
When we roll it up, it goes up to the classes table.
Before they can think about sharing for themselves and earning the big bucks,
we'll destroy it, yeah?
Jack, Gemma, and Tommy must prove they've mastered the basics and are competent shed hands.
Nearly!
With each fleece worth around £40, there is serious money at stake.
Yeah, I'm not doing too badly, actually, no. I feel like I'm getting the nick of it a bit more.
For me, this is the hardest job I've done so far.
Is it physically hard or?
No.
No, it's mentally hard,
yeah,
isn't it?
Yeah.
Yeah.
Cheers!
Thanks.
Thank you. As their first payday approaches, Jack's starting to realise that this trip could be about more than just making a quick buck.
I might actually stay on home, thinking about it. If I can get hang of it.
So you're obviously liking it.
Yeah, yeah, yeah. Do you know what I mean? It's just so chilled back. It's so much better than me back in England.
And everyone looks after each other.
Everyone looks after each other. It's not constant internet. It's not traffic. It's not street lamps. It's just proper laid back. It's a proper decent lifestyle. Yeah, I'm considering like staying here for a bit longer. Not only because it's an absolutely beautiful country, but it's like a family's working together. And I know they're staying on for a couple of months. I'm just thinking I might stay on for a couple of months as well.
Back at base, the early starts aren't getting any easier.
I've had about 4 hours sleep. I'm always this tired every morning because I never have any sleep, and it's weird. I literally normally have about 8 hours sleep, and this is, I'm just not even used to this yet.
I'm just not a morning person. I'm not accurate. I'm too tired all the time. I'm shattered. Absolutely shattered.
If Jack's serious about staying on, he's going to have to prove to Mouse he's ready to take the next step.
Now we'll see how you go pinning up, eh?
All right, OK.
And if they're going to be shearing, he and Gemma need to be confident handling the sheep, so it's back in the pens for both of them.
Better get those sheep out of the way so you can get to the gate. Oh! That's it, good stuff.
On her first day in the pens, Gemma was reduced to tears.
Yay, I can get in.
Now, she's starting to show the sheep who's in charge.
Yeah, get in, get in, get the hell in.
Jack has really surprised me. He's using a bit of muscle, eh?
This is the hardest thing.
I've got early chest, I feel like an 8-year-old.
I am feeling pleased myself, just exhausted, but who would have thought I'd be doing that ever in my lifetime, ever? It's absolutely bizarre, but it's mint. It's absolutely mint.
This is the hardest job I've ever done, ever, ever. I didn't think anything will ever top this.
Gemma, that was a big improvement.
Oh, thanks.
I thought you went really good.
Oh, thank you.
Yeah, I feel really good to myself. I feel like I've just, like, conquered something that I didn't think I would ever conquer. Like, you know, when I came in, I was, like, crying for, like, I've been nearly in tears, like, 50 times here, like, and I'm just freaking not even cared, like, passed it all by and just been like, I'll just do it. I'm out of breath. I need a beer.
Showing the Sharing Gang that there's more to her than just hair and makeup is a big deal for Gemma.
I feel like some people just like look at me like, well, she looks too young and girly and she won't work. She just wants to have her nails done all the time. That's all, that's it.
But for Gemma, her look isn't a matter of choice.
The makeup, clothing, all this type of thing is a sort of prop that she can use to sort of not quite hide behind but boost her own self-esteem.
I can't go outside the house without looking nice because I feel like when you look good, you feel good, and I feel like everyone's gonna be looking at you like, oh my God, she looks amazing, and I like that feeling. So I have to have that feeling.
New Zealand has been quite a culture shock for Gemma, and not just when it comes to hard work. When she arrived a fortnight ago, workmate Stevie and Tui didn't know what to make of their glamorous new shed hand.
I thought, oh, look at this lady. What is she doing? She's got the wrong gear on. I just thought that you were too girly, actually.
Yeah.
We feel comfortable in our natural skin.
Mm.
Like, everyone is happy to walk around in, like, trackies and a hoodie and still feel beautiful.
Yeah. Well, I have been kind of dressing down more, like, and then I've not been wearing, like, as much makeup and stuff. It's just kind of, like, more, like, natural. I mean, I think the main thing that annoys me is the money situation, how much money I spend on it.
Yeah.
Do you know what I mean?
I wouldn't be this skint now if it wasn't for all that. And sad that, you know, I feel like you're a little bit insecure about yourself and you're so beautiful.
And you shouldn't have.
And you shouldn't be.
Maybe that's what it is then. Maybe I'm just insecure.
A little insecure.
But why? I don't know.
You look better without it.
I look better without makeup.
Yeah.
Gemma, Jack and Tomi have survived two back-breaking weeks in New Zealand and are about to see what that means for their pockets.
Hi.
Hi.
G'day.
Hi.
Here's yours, Jack.
Their hourly rate here is double the UK minimum wage, so they've each pocketed nearly 700 quid, more than any of them have earned before.
What the hell?
That's a lot.
Are you taking a mic?
I like all these colours.
Are you taking a mic? That's bloody loads.
That's like half my credit cards. Well, one of my credit cards.
That's like one of my credit cards, mate.
Thank you so much.
Thank you.
Enjoy yourself
tomorrow. I've never had this amount of cash in my hand that I've earned.
That is a lot of money.
Team for us. Smiling,
that's your like travel money for boxing side out. That's
fuel enough. Money, food money.
Sorry.
You're sorted. For a couple months now.
That's
yeah.
it, a month and a half.
Freaking give me the next sheet.
It's
now.
Worth the 5 o'clock mornings
that's
now, though,
all of a sudden.
Innit?
You get, this is the spur you want, do it.
But next week, they'll get the chance to earn even more by learning to shear for themselves. And if they can stick it out in the wool sheds, they could get the chance to extend their stay with the Shearing Gang. With money burning a hole in her pocket, Gemma heads straight for the nearest beauty salon.
Hi, I've come to get my nails taken off.
Sure.
They're getting in my way at work, so I need them off, I've decided.
See you later, nails.
Yeah.
For the first time, something matters more to Gemma than looking good.
My job's more important, the money's more important than my nails. Don't need them. No one really has nails and stuff, so I'm not really impressing anyone much. So yeah, I'm not really that arsed. Normally I'd be like crying, yeah.
With just 2 weeks remaining, the trainees are finally ready to get their hands on the shears.
Aren't you worried that like everyone's gonna all the shit in, people are shearing sheep and we're doing like one every 2 hours?
Even the sheep's gonna turn around and be like, oh, you know what, I'll just do it myself.
Shearing a whole sheep is a skill that takes time to master. So today, the novices will be starting at the bottom, literally.
Right, we're going to get into a bit of crutching today. So we're going to shear off around their bums. Okay, so this is the first thing you're going to do on the handpiece, okay? So we're going to shear them off. This is where you start making real good money. All right, so we're just backing out where the handpiece is sitting. We're sitting it down.
I'm going to lose my fingers, mate.
always got to have control, and it's no use starting if you haven't got control. Right, hand piece off when I finish. And just walk it to the porthole.
This is what I've been waiting for, this. Learn how to do this, it's how you get paid.
After a masterclass from Mouse that made it look easy, Jack's first to discover that it really isn't.
If you hit it right in here, you can kick the handpiece
around. Get your toes in like that.
That's good, yep. You're all right, buddy. You're all right. You're all right. You got it, mate. You got it. You got it, mate.
Yeah. Fucking fuck.
Good to go.
Shuffle back, straighten your legs up. Good. It's a very strange feeling to be shaving a sheep's ass. It's also, in a weird way, quite an achievement. It's bizarre to say that about shaving a sheep's ass, but it's cool.
It's going to pull me down
that
way.
Go down that way.
That's it,
push it
down.
Oh, Jack, I don't know how much money you're going to make today, but it's going to be fuck all.
Next, it's Gemma's turn to see if she can cut it.
Awesome, girl.
Awesome. That is the heaviest thing.
Right, here you go. Take that in your right hand.
Your legs are hurting already, is that right?
Your legs are hurting. You haven't actually started yet.
I know. Okay.
Shearers are regularly kicked and butted, but there are particular hazards when shearing a sheep's backside.
That's alright. Have a little wash off. It's only warm. Oh,
you're right.
Got one of the
girls
to help you.
All good.
And crutching isn't just about brute strength. Above all, it's about technique.
Nice, mate. Push it off. Chuck it out. Pull that off.
Well done, Tommy.
Nice, mate.
Buzzing. Money in the bank.
I think I enjoy the shearing the most because I know that's where I'm going to earn the most money and I want to be doing the top job.
Next day and it's crunch time. The sheep are bigger and there are lots of them, but gang leader Harmy is still expecting his novice shearers to pull their weight.
This is where the hard grafting stuff, the sweat and the pain and the frustration, the laughter, the crying.
Me not now.
This is where we're going to find out if we're going to walk out or not.
I don't want.
No longer paid by the hour, the rookie shearers will earn just 15 pence a sheep. So they'll need to get through 60 an hour just to match what they earned as shed hands. Which is more likely for some than others.
Paid 20 quid for this down at Salon. Nice Brazilian.
Freaking knackered.
For the rest of the afternoon, the trainees do their best to make a dent on the flock.
Yeah.
Oh, please. Yep, that's it.
Oh, no.
Come here.
Oh, you.
Nearly.
He may not have done 60 an hour, but Tommy has impressed his gang leader.
Full credit to him, 26 for the hour. Second day on a handpiece, yeah, that's a great achievement by anyone's standards.
Well, essentially, I'll admit, not even $9, so it's like £4.50.
But Gemma's tallies are lower, much lower.
I think I've done about 16 today, so that's not even, what is that? It's like freaking $5, isn't it? Not even that. It's just so bloody heavy.
For Jack, being paid on commission has been a wake-up call.
Back.
His numbers are even lower than Gemma's.
My back sore. Today I've done 12 sheep in total, which is 15p a sheep. So today I've made £1.20 in English pounds, which is absolutely rubbish.
I'm going to keep having a go at shearing sheep, but if I can't do it, then I can't stay in that area. Like, because I'm not going to make any money, I'm going to come home with absolutely nothing.
It is all about the money.
It's all about the money.
Speed, I think, is most crucial, because if you don't have the speed, there's just no point in you carrying on doing it, because at the end of the day, personal achievement isn't going to pay off my credit cards and stuff.
As they approach the end of their third week in New Zealand, Tommy, Jack and Gemma are facing their biggest test so far. A contract to crutch 1,500 Merino sheep but only one day to turn the job round. It's the perfect chance for three eager young shearers to make up for yesterday's losses. But the early starts, exhausting work and 30-degree heat are beginning to take their toll.
My back's really, really sore. It's absolutely killing me.
It is the hardest job I've ever done. You're getting marched, you're getting bruised, getting kicked, you're getting headbutted. It's mental.
Just relax, Jack.
Okay. Jack especially is finding it tough going.
Jack's really struggling. He's struggling because they're kicking a bit on him and fighting.
Oh, it's just frustrated. My back is absolutely killing me. I don't know if it's because, like, the last few days I've been all right and, like, today it's just finally kicked in, but I'm so much agony. And it's hot. I just feel dirty because the washing machine doesn't even work properly back at the quarters. I just feel horrible. Tried to prove people, you know, I'd get through it, but I can't do it. I've tried. I've really tried.
Back at base, Mouse has concerns.
The farmer had 1,500. Yeah. And with you three guys crutching, that job wouldn't have got done today.
I think if we had time to invest, I would have tried to carry on a couple more like one-to-ones and stuff, but
yeah,
we don't have the time for that.
Yeah. We've got a period of time and I think we should just go with what we're best at.
Yeah. Mm-hmm.
But at the end of the day, it's about making money, isn't it?
Yeah.
And you two guys just look at wool handling and making money wool handling. Yeah. And I think that's the
way
you're going to make it.
That's perfect for me,
you know. Yeah,
that's
me
made
too.
Me feel better.
Mm-hmm. Well, Tommy, if you want to have a good go at crutching, you've got to make that decision.
I love the crutching and I enjoy it, whereas the wool handling, I absolutely despise it.
All right, 5 o'clock tomorrow morning.
Yeah, see you there.
Yeah.
It's the trainee's final week and Mouse has a reward for Tommy, his own shearing kit.
She's in a bit.
Miss
have a good
you.
Day.
It'll be weird.
Ooh. I like I said, if I kid off
luck.
To school.
First day of school.
Go.
I've got me.
You got your bottle bag. And you got your lunch.
Yes.
For the first time, Gemma, Jack and Tommy are going their separate ways. While Jack and Gemma are going where they know they can make money, wool handling, Tommy's decided to stick with Harmy on commission-based shearing. It's a financial gamble and a huge challenge, but when it comes to drive and determination, Tommy has a good role model.
My dad might technically be my stepdad, but he's my dad. He's basically one of the strongest men that I know because he's got cerebral sclerosis and whatever nervous system it lands on, it just knackers. But he doesn't moan, he just gets on. He knows that stuff's going to happen and knows that we're all going to be there for him, so he just gets on and just that's why, because he's a soldier.
How come you don't use them other crutches? They're cooler.
If I wanted to, like, shake someone's hand, I ended up twatting them with stick.
When I'm training and I find it so hard and I'm literally knackered, crawling, and I think to myself, well, my dad wishes he could walk without sticks and I'm able to walk here and I'm not. Come on, fuck yourself up.
For Tommy's gamble to pay off, he's going to have to work fast, as he'll only be paid per sheep he crutches.
It's like a wrestling match with an 85-kilo animal every single minute.
But with Harmy setting the pace alongside him, Tommy's numbers are up.
D86, mommy.
Great.
Well done.
Yeah. It was sort of a wake-up call today. Like, previously I've got tired. You'd, like, someone would jump in or do something, or you'd be like, just have a breather. But I didn't want to let you down as well, you know, as well as myself.
You've surprised quite a few of us, didn't you? You've sort of, like, taken it to it, like, duck to water, basically, really.
Cool beans.
it's just a numbers game for you now. You know, tell me, where does your drive and that come from?
My dad used to be a sports person and that, but then obviously he got ill and he sort of helps me through. When I'm fighting, I'm knackered or I'm training, I just think, well, my dad's going through this, and not once does he ever moan, and he gets on with it, so I've got to get on with it. First memory I have of my dad was me and old mates playing footy, and then my dad was like, he come across, and I hadn't known him too long, instead of playing footy was, I'd never had like a dad, like, you know.
Yeah, mate. Yeah, well, I'm sure your dad would be quite proud of you if you've seen what he done, what you achieved today. You know, you'd be really smiling from ear to ear. Yeah, treasure every moment you got, man. Because before you know it, you know, tomorrow may never come. My dad got sick within 3 months, he's gone.
Yeah.
And you don't realise it until they're gone.
Yeah.
You know? How much I wanted to ask him, you know, I wanted to talk to him about certain things, and now it's too late, I'll never get that chance.
I'd need to start showing my dad how I feel. I don't want them regrets, like what harm he's got, and I don't want negative thoughts of what I could have and should have said, because I do love him, I love him to bits, and I'd be lost without him, so about time I started showing it.
Back in their comfort zone, wall handling with Adam and being paid by the hour, it's a chance for Jack and Gemma to earn some proper cash again.
I'd like to be rousing more. And I don't feel that as much as, like, under pressure when I'm
cheering. It's like a relief going back to this. It's nice, really nice.
In 4 days, the trainees are due to fly home. But without the stress of shearing, and with another 11 months on his working holiday visa, Jack is once again pondering the benefits of staying on.
Have I woke you up? It's Jack. Yeah, you.
He's hoping a call home to his sister will help him decide.
What would you do in my situation? Would you know, I'll stay here, sort your debts out, or come back home?
Oh, we want you to come home. We want you home.
What do you think Mum will say, like?
She's got you home, I think.
You think?
Yeah.
Well, that's a bit of a shocker. But what, I thought, why would she want me home? Is that what she's been saying to you while I've been here?
Yeah, she's been
worried,
asking me if I
know something. I didn't know that. I definitely need to have a word, because I wasn't expecting her to say that, especially after all these years and that.
Hearing that his mum is missing him has thrown Jack's plans of staying into doubt. With time running out, he has a difficult decision to make.
It's hard. It's really hard. What was it like when you came out, or did you even come out?
I've been out since I was probably about 13. Yeah, I came out.
You told your mum?
Yeah, I told my mum. My mum didn't like it. So I left home when I was 16. I went and lived with my auntie. And it was either accepted or not. But she did.
She accepted it.
I reckon your mum's hurting.
For what?
For you.
Yeah.
That's what I reckon.
So what would you do in my situation then?
I really think that you should sit down and have a really good talk with your mother so that she knows where you're coming from and how you feel about it and what you want from her. At the end of the day, I really think your mum does love you.
Maybe I do need to talk to her. I'd like to try and sort it, because it would be nice to be a, you know, a proper unit rather than I see my sister and not my mum. It would mean the world to me.
Tomorrow, Jack, along with Tommy and Gemma, is supposed to be flying home. So after 4 back-breaking weeks in New Zealand, it's time for that all-important pay packet. But will the hard work have been worth it?
Thank you.
Thanks a lot.
Going back to wall handling means Gemma and Jack were limited to the hourly rate.
What the hell?
She was well done.
Oh, thank you.
Thanks a lot. It's been a pleasure having you.
Before tax, they've each earned £1,500.
That is a lot.
Yeah.
That's
a little bit.
Yeah.
Since I got here, I've earned over $3,000, which is like I did not expect that at all, so like it's amazing.
Pretty much on the verge of being debt free, so it's a massive amount. Like back in the UK, like I would never have made that money in a month, ever.
By sticking with crutching, Tommy took a gamble.
Well done.
And it's paid off. He's walking away with nearly £2,000.
I've worked my ass off for that money. I've woken up with bad backs, bad necks. I don't think this apartment is good, but it's all worth it. I'm using the money for training, and then I want to do something nice for my parents because they do so much for me. So just to come and get great money like I have and be able to do that is just a massive thing for me.
I'm not going to pack any of my tan or any of that, so I'm going to leave that here.
And for the first time, Gemma's planning to spend her money on something other than herself.
It'll make me feel good paying my mum back because I know I worked that hard for it. This is the hardest job I've ever done, and it's just like, why am I taking money off my parents? They need it. I don't even need it. I'm just using it for the sake of it because I want to get bloody nails done. So I really just, as soon as I get home, I'm going to pay them. Like, I just, that's the one thing I've realised. Like, I shouldn't have been doing all that.
The question is, will Jack be joining them on the plane home?
Taking that back with me. Memorabilia. I could have earned so much more money here from working because it's so much better than like the UK wage and stuff, and it is a lot of money that comes into your pay packet. But it seems I've been given the chance to sort things out with my mum. I'm going to try and give that a go. And family is extremely important, so looking forward to going home and trying to make things work.
After 4 long weeks, time to say goodbye.
This experience, it's taught me a trade where I can earn money. It's taught me so much about myself and what I can and can't do.
Before here, I was just like this fake thing, walking around like big air and that. And now I'm just like not worrying about what people think and wanting to pay my mum and dad back, which normally I wouldn't do. And I just feel like a completely different person. I don't think anyone's going to recognise me.
The job has been so exhausting. But it's nice. You just feel like contentment. You've worked hard, but you've got good money for it as well, definitely.
I'm just so proud of those 3 guys. Like, Gemma, Jack and Tommy have just blown my mind, to be quite honest. They just got right in, got on with everyone and done the job that they've been asked to do.
After a 36-hour trip, Gemma is home.
Hey!
Hey! Oh, God!
Thanks for the banners. Like, I've never had that before.
Like, get on!
Come on, just like a jersey thing.
And there's a surprise for Mum and Dad.
Right, listen, right. I've done so much work here, right? Mm-hmm. I'm giving you me money for it.
Ooh! This is all your hard-earned money, and you're giving it to us?
Yeah. There you go.
Thank you.
All right.
Thank you. Wow! Gem! Thank you.
It's all right. Do I look like a changed person?
You're very changed.
Especially if you're just giving you money, which I never do.
Love it. I love it. I'm loving the new Gem.
Hey, hey!
Meanwhile, Tommy's also being reunited with his parents.
Being away, sort of realised, you know, you miss your family. I've sort of realised how much you support us, me boxing, how much you're always there for us no matter what. And I do only appreciate you a bit. You were stuck with me because you gave birth to me, but you took us on, so cheers, Dad.
Love you. I do fucking love you as well.
A few months later, the money he made abroad means Jack's moved on.
So this is my new house now. I don't have black mould on my wall, which, of course, is a massive improvement on my old place.
Since returning...